Hello everyone, this is Sheila Ratna Bansoode from Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Today we are going to see the topic sections of solids, and in that particularly we will be looking into cylinders. Learning outcomes: students will be able to draw the sectional view of cylinder. At this moment of the video, I suggest you all to pause the video and remember or recollect the shape of cylinder or the structure of cylinder. As you all know, cylinder is a solid of revolution which is obtained by rotating a rectangular plane in 360 degrees about its longer side. The cylinder does not have edges, it has generators, it has a top base and a bottom base and no edges. Let us move further. Example: a cylinder base 40 mm diameter, 60 mm height, has its axis vertical, is cut by sectional plane perpendicular to VP, inclined at 45 degrees to HP, and intersecting the axis 32 mm above the base. Draw the front view, sectional top view, sectional side view. Think over this question. First, we have a cylinder whose base and top diameters are 40 mm. Its height or axis height is 60 mm, and it is resting with its axis vertical, that is, it is resting on HP. It is cut by a plane perpendicular to VP and inclined at 45 degrees to HP. Now, as the cutting plane is perpendicular to VP, it will be seen as a line view in front view, and the same plane is inclined at 45 degrees to HP, which will also be seen in front view. So we'll have the cutting plane as a line inclined at 45 degrees to XY in the front view, and this line passes through the axis at a point 32 mm above the base of the cylinder. Let us start the drawing. XY line. As the cylinder is resting on HP, we start with the top view by drawing a circle of diameter 40 mm. As the cylinder will be seen a circle, we'll divide this circle in equal number of parts. Now here, students can divide the circle in minimum of 8 number of parts and maximum up to 12. The more the number of parts, the better the sketching or the drawing of the section could be. Let us move to complete the front view. We'll name the points. We'll project the points in front view along with the axis. We measure the height as 60 mm and draw the cylinder. So this is the front view and top view of the cylinder resting on HP with its axis vertical. So axis vertical is this. We'll name the parts. Now we'll move further. It is cut by a section plane. We'll project the cylinder in the side view as shown, and we'll complete the cylinder in side view. Now coming to the section plane, you can see the red line indicates the section plane or the cutting plane, which is inclined at 45 degrees to HP, perpendicular to VP, seen as a line view, and 32 mm above the base. So this is the position of your cutting plane. Now, as we require to draw sectional side view, for that reason we have completed or we have initiated to draw the side view. Now let us consider the points where this cutting plane cuts the generators of the cylinder. We'll name those points as P1, P2 and P8, P3 and P7, P4 and P6 and P5. So these are the points where the cutting plane cuts the generators of the cylinder. We'll move further. We'll project point P1, which is the point on generator 1, 1 dash or 1 dash, 1 dash in the side view. So P1 is projected on 1 dash, 1 dash generator in side view to obtain point P1. Similarly, we will obtain all the points from P1 to P5, P8, P7 and P6 in the side view. So this is the structure of the section when it is cut by a plane which is inclined at 45 degrees to HP. We have named all the points on the corresponding generators. Like P1, we have taken it on 1, 1. P2, we have it on 2. And P8 on 8 generators. Similarly, P3 and P7. P3 on 3, 3 dash, 3 dash. P7 on 7 dash, 7 dash. Similarly, P6 and P4 and P5. We'll join all the points. So this is the section or the portion that has been cut by this cutting plane. We'll dark the remaining part of the cylinder as when it is cut in this fashion, this portion or the upper portion or the portion above the cutting plane is removed and remaining section is as shown in on screen. Now let us move to the second example. A cylinder base 50 mm diameter, 70 mm height lies on HP on one of its generators such that axis is inclined at 40 degrees to VP. And passes through the farthest point of visible base from the observer, full stop, draw the projections. Here we have a cylinder of diameter 50 mm and height 70 mm and it is resting on one of its generators such that the axis is inclined at 40 degrees to VP. Now inclination with VP is seen in top view. So let us move further with a solution. XY line. Now as it is inclined to VP, we start with front view. That means we have considered the cylinder to be resting in VP. Thus, we can see the cylinder as a circle in front view. We divide the cylinder in equal number of parts. We move further to complete the front view, top view, with a height of 70 mm. We name the parts or we name the generators. This is the position or the initial position of the cylinder which is resting in VP with its axis perpendicular to VP or axis parallel to HP. Now we'll move to the second condition. In this case, we have to draw or redraw the top view or the first top view with the axis. This point 3 dash 7 dash axis inclined at 45 degrees to VP. So here we have redrawn this figure here with the axis inclined to XY at 45 degrees. Now let us move further to complete the front view. We'll project the point from second top view to front view. Like point 1 dash is projected and corresponding point from the previous top view is projected to obtain the point 1. Similarly, 0.5, 0.1 from one base, 0.5 from the same base. We have obtained the points 1, 1 and 5, 5 in the second front view. Similarly, we project all the points and obtain the cylinder in front view. So these are the faces, the top face and the bottom face of the cylinder when it is inclined at 45 degrees to VP. We'll join the curves. So this is the projection of cylinder for this current position. Now coming further, the cutting plane passes to the farthest visible point of the base. Here is the observer. The observer is standing here. This corner is the nearest corner, whereas this corner is the farthest corner or far away corner from the observer of the visible base. As this base is visible, thus the cutting plane passes through the point which is away from the observer and which is on the visible base of the cylinder. So this is the visible base and this base is not seen directly. So the cutting plane passes through this base. Now here we mark the points where the cutting plane cuts the generators. We name them as P1 to P8. Moving further, so these are the points where cutting plane cuts the cylinder. Now let us project these points P1 to P8 in the second front view. Likewise, P1 is the point on 1-1. We have projected it vertically upwards on the generator or the projection from the previous front view to obtain 1, P1. Similarly, P2 and P8 from the top view and second generator and 8th generator to obtain P2 and P8. Similarly, we have obtained P3 and P7, P4 and P6 and P5. So this is the section view of the cylinder when it is cut in this fashion. We'll join all the points on obtained the sectional view. We'll dark the remaining edges. As here, this portion does not remain, this portion is not remaining. So this is the only portion that remains when the cylinder is cut with the cutting plane in the given fashion. Thank you.